Hello, it's the 27th of March 2018. I'm in Vienna, the capital of Austria, and I'm about to catch this train to go to this banknote. I've discovered I'm a bit jealous of people who live in Vienna. Not only is it a fantastic city in itself, but you can hop on a train, head southwest for just 45 minutes, and you're here. Try doing exactly that same thing in London, and you'll end up in Basingstoke. Instead, I'm in Semmering, and I've come here to explore some beautiful alpine mountain scenery, and find out more about the story of the railway that goes right through the middle of it. But first, some music. Take it away, train. Nice. Now, this area is hiking heaven. We're almost 900 metres up in the Alps, and I've been told the trails around here have some spectacular views. I'm aiming for the 20 Schilling Blick, a view that was made famous after appearing on Austria's old 20 Schilling banknotes. Looks like it's this way. To get there, I'm taking a trail called the Bahn van der Weg, which follows the Semmering Railway as it cuts through the mountains on a string of viaducts and tunnels. Construction started on the line in 1848. 1848! Stevenson's rocket is still a teenager. There's no electrical equipment, there are no cars, everything has to be transported by horse. It's 20 years before the Celt to Carlisle line even goes over the Pennines, and they've built this. Now, at this point of the hike, you're inside a huge loop of the railway line, and I can only apologise for this reference, but as you walk above the valley in the shadow of the trees, you'll find this lookout point, and if you climb to the top, you'll literally be living in a train spotter's paradise. What you're surrounded by here is the engineering genius of Carlo Geiger. Here he is on the other side of the 20 shilling note. Born in Venice in 1802 to Albanian parents, he was involved in the construction of Austria's first ever railways, and by the age of 40 he was entrusted with the planning of the entire Austrian state railway. It was Geiger who had the vision to build a line over the Alps, and the engineering skills to make it happen. There's a museum dedicated to Geiger a little further down the trail, next to one of his most impressive structures, the Kalterinner Viaduct. Walking through this rugged terrain, you really begin to appreciate how tough it must have been to build a railway in such a hostile environment. And all this at a time when no existing train would have been able to cope with it. No one had ever built a train capable of handling these kinds of gradients and curves, because no one had ever needed to. A competition was held to find a design that would weigh less than 14 tons and maintain a speed of 11.5 kilometers an hour. Four companies entered the contest, and amazingly, all four locomotives completed the trial successfully. Problem was, in practice, none of them proved reliable. In the end, a fifth design was used, by Wilhelm Freiherr von Engert. Now here's the science. His innovation was to incorporate the locomotive and its tender into one frame, with articulated rear wheels. This put more weight on the driving wheels than in a traditional tender engine, and therefore increased traction and adhesion, with the articulation allowing it to still negotiate tight curves. Back to the trail, and I've now reached the 20 Schilling Blick. There's a helpful information board with a picture of what the banknote used to look like. Unfortunately, the weather isn't great today, it's a bit grey and misty. But you have to admit, it's still a pretty good view. From here, the hiking trail loops back on itself to give you a closer look at some of the line's beautifully constructed viaducts. Geiger had them built out of local stone with the aim of blending in and complementing the landscape. I don't know about you, but I reckon he did a decent job. And they're not just beautiful. They're incredibly well engineered, which means they still carry trains today after more than 160 years. This is the Unterer Adlitzgraben Viaduct, and this is the Kalte Rinne. If you like trains, I recommend bringing spare underwear. The state of that football pitch. As we enter the village of Brighton, Stein, we're now coming towards the end of my hike. This is one of many villages that grew as a direct result of the railway. We don't even think about it now, but in the 1850s, very few people would ever go into the mountains. The only way of getting there was on your own 2 feet, or if you're lucky, you might convince a horse to take you. The Semmeringbahn gave people access to the Alps, and at the time it would have been an almost unique tourist experience. In fact, this railway made a huge contribution to the growth of mountaineering and winter sports as something that people actually did. If you'd like to explore the history of the Semmeringbahn and see these views for yourself, then I thoroughly recommend walking the Bahn van der Weg. It's very easy to follow, just look for these symbols on the signposts. You can do the whole walk from Semmering to Breitenstein in about 2.5 to 3 hours, depending on how many photographs you want to take. If you like trains, on the other hand, best book a week off work. Thanks very much for watching. I'll be doing more videos about travel, trekking and transport, so please subscribe if you'd like more of this kind of thing, and I'll see you soon.